Hello world of YouTube and welcome to another episode of Redacted, the show where I take a look at records that have a solid foundation but a spotty execution and making a smoother listening experience out of it all. And this month we're going to finally be diverting back to a theme I wanted to do far more often this year, the year of the debut, by taking a look at two mixtapes that dropped in 2010 by a group that influenced my style of rapping a lot more than I would have ever thought that they would, but in hindsight make a lot of sense, given how much I was listening to these mixtapes when they came out, and I feel like are the next step or the next benchmark met in, like, self-aware slash postmodernism, ironic hip-hop, while having this really nice pen game. Talking about the two mixtapes of Sit Down Man and Shut Up Dude by Das Racist that I'm pulling together and calling Sit Down Man, parentheses, Shut Up Dude.
Catch me at the crib getting light to Jeff Mangum. It's fun to do bad things like rhyme about handguns. If any problem pop off.
Now for those who don't know who Das Racist are, which is understandable, they haven't been a group for 10 years now. They were a rap trio consisting of frontmen Heems and Kool AD with hype man Dapwell also in the mix. They dropped three projects, these two mixtapes and an album. And the best way I can kind of describe Das Racist for those who don't know is, to me, they felt like the next notch in the belt of, like, postmodern, self-aware, ironic music. They were equal parts funny and well-penned. Sure, they had songs that were comedic and jokey and played into that stoner rap scene that they definitely felt like they were adding to. They also sort of did a good job at showcasing their perspective in the world, especially in the case of when dealing with, you know, the many white people that would say really stupid racist shit to minorities, including them. And I loved what these guys brought to the table in all facets. I mean, this was a Redacted that feels less in line with, like, a spotty execution and more just trying to bring together two projects that really influenced me. And my goal today was less to fix these projects and more bring them together into a harmonious marriage. And the big difference between Sit Down Man and Shut Up Dude is Shut Up Dude was the first mixtape and acts as sort of a proof of concept of this group. It has that everything that I talked about without a lot of collaboration influence, whereas Sit Down Man sees them coming together with a handful of people in the independent music scene, not just in hip-hop, and sort of further expanding on the ideas from Shut Up Dude. While I did cut tracks from both, a lot of both of these mixtapes is shown in prominence. This is definitely a beefier Redacted out of the ones I've done because I enjoy these two projects so very much. And my best sort of advice, if you do want to listen to this Redacted, is to follow their advice. Maybe spark up or roll one maybe before throwing it on. It's definitely not for a casual hip-hop vibe session. You know, you're not going to listen to it like you do a Raekwon project or like an Aesop Rock project. It's got a melding of ideas that I think work very well, and I more wanted to create a good flow across this double album sized experience while not losing the heart of this project and this group in the process. My version of Sit Down Man, Shut Up Dude is 26 songs and an hour and 40 minutes. So let's go ahead and break down the track listing, but first, I'm gonna show you the track listing in full.
That's why I said, why not?
Oh, I.
Sit down, man.
Whack, backstreet, street back, alley cat, rally that, Taliban, alley man, minivan, van.
Talk about how, like, white people can't even go outside into the sunlight without contracting a disease.
Rugged rain, timid, lame, staying lame, change range, love it, main brum with stained jeans on the corner.
We at the Pizza Hut.
No.
We at the Taco Bell.
No.
We at the combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell.
You took a lot of samples out, you don't gotta clear those. Made a lot of weird raps, you don't wanna hear those. Labels like maybe
some may I say, call me Heems. The word is the herb and I'm deep like
dust, but now we work with several cats. I still live off severance cash, self-aware of reverend cats. That's racist.
Like a tree or the tears of a clown. Yo, I'm afraid of clowns, I'm afraid of small town.
Go Sunoco flow, no Pinocchio. No BP, just beat me, meet me.
Chase evasion paper, like with Twitter, yeah. Sick of arguing with white dudes on the internet.
Papa watch me on the Google alerts. Hi dad, I'm at the Whitney with DJ Spooky on an iPad.
Karis One did a fake patois. Miss Clue got a fake patois. Even Jay-Z did a fake patois.
Hit dashiki, your girl sex me, she wanna get freaky. She beat me, meet me at team rolling dice, man. Something like the dice man. Nice man, brown man, white like me. I don't do that, dog. I rap about me. And I ain't splashy, I am the sea.
I see that's misleading. Lamping in the basement, lamps for crossbreeding. Got a day job, old earth water.
More rhymes than Jay Alec got. Rama Lama Ding Dong Dama Lama Parmesan cheese on the ravioli.
Morning, I'm out the door storming. Maybe towards like a rooftop or a barbecue or something.
Eating a Cuban sandwich, I'm puking. Trying to write some rap tracks in Sanskrit.
I know I don't like it, it's lame, my friend. Everything always the same, my friend. Even when everything changed.
Shorty said I look like the veins of Bernhardt. Shorty said I look like that dude from Japan's art. You know the dude who
I get it in every day like white socks. And I'm gonna come up like the right stock.
Ex Shanice, sheesh, Eddie Saeed speaks, sheesh. Yeah, that's what Ed said. You people so pony boy. Machio man Randy. Scandalous savages more noble.
Shut up, dude.
Shut up already.
Now it's a mixtape. We got an intro. It says sit down man and it's great. Then we go into Nutmeg. A version of Nutmeg that inspired the second verse of my version of Nutmeg.
That's amazing.
That's amazing.
That's racist.
Got me chasing to the vacant vacancies like a spaceship.
It embodies the camaraderie, the pen game, and the jovialness that this project is going to have while just spitting over a classic Wu-Tang joint. Something that kind of, again, embodies a lot of this record as a whole from like a sample choice, beat choice front. It's a quality track that I think comes off of intro pretty amicably before going into All Tan Everything, a little more of a comedic leaning joint that whose core idea is all tan, you know, tan men, brown men, everything is tan, while also taking jabs at white people for a lack of melanin and how that could be a problem for them when fighting the sun. It's a really fun track that I wanted to use to kind of show the other aspect of the group's style a little more overtly, while also having a blatant heavy usage of a Jay-Z sample for the hook, again sort of embodying mixtape culture and that sort of late 2000s, early 2010s vibe within mixtape culture that I wanted to reinforce before spinning into another remix of the Fat Tony song, Love It Maine. I think the guys handled the track really well, and it's one of the few tracks that has like an overt hook that I feel like, given this point in the record or a couple tracks in, it keeps the listener kind of invested in that sort of facet, while also, again, showing just some of that sharp pen game with some of that postmodern quirkiness that the group does very, very well. It also has this sort of planting moment with some bars that reference a Millie by Lil Wayne, something that happens a couple times, a handful of times, throughout these mixtapes, and I keep one of them early on the record and one later on the record, but this is the one from early on, and it's, again, it's just a nice track that sort of acts as sort of a good easing into early track, deep cut territory. And from there, we pivot into the first real huge joke song and the biggest song that Das Racist, I think, has ever done. It's a song that still crops up in pop culture because of how much of a splash it kind of made at the time, I guess. But it's Combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell. And I'm just waiting for the day that Pitchfork or maybe even some other basic-ass clickbaity site like BuzzFeed does an article on whatever happened to the Combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell on Jamaica Avenue referenced in the song. Because the way these guys talk about it makes it sound like a perfect place to be. But yeah, it's a song that I felt like had to be here. Because it is something that's become bigger than Das Racist as a whole, at least to me anyway, because it's the only track from this era I've ever heard, like, still show up before going into You Can Sell Anything to kind of spit in the face of having that song be so fucking huge. And tangentially jumping from that into a song that further explores the brown man stereotyping and observance from white people with Who's That Brown. Another song that samples a hip-hop classic in the form of Scenario. They reference that song and some of the bars on here.
Now some may I say, call me Heems.
But it's the song that opens Shut Up Dude, and I think it's a really good song. I think that the beat goes hard. It's equal parts quirky and weird and dope as fuck. And it fits really nicely in this pocket of the record where we're getting really out there and outlandish with Combination Pizza Hut. You can't sell anything, or you can sell anything. And the follow-up to Who's That Brown with Return to Innocence, a song where the guys are rapping over the Pure Moods and Enigma classic.
Imagine a world where time drifts slowly. A world where music carries you away.
Return to Innocence, which, hilariously enough, Enigma was sued for his sample in the original. And I love how the guys flip that on this. They do what they do on tracks like People Are Strange and You Wanna Know by singing the hook itself. And still chopping up some good bars amidst that camaraderie that is showcased, and showcasing some laid-back, again, weed-style raps that I think comes across fantastically before flipping into the big single these guys were trying to push in Rainbow in the Dark, which showcases that well-penned game that was in parts of Return to Innocence a little more sharply. You know, they may have sparked up on Return to Innocence, but they're definitely riding that wave tenfold on Rainbow in the Dark. And it's a really good song. It's one that was remixed with Anamanaguchi. It was a song they were really pushing heavily, and I can see why. It's got a lot of good components at it that lean into that early 2010s hip-hop scene pretty well, in my opinion. But guys, we're getting too bogged down with dope bars. Let's take a little bit of a deviation. Let's take that smoothness that we're rolling in. Let's sample the Days of Our Lives theme and make a song where the hook is just talking about how you're joking, or that you're not joking, but you are joking, and you're not joking, in the form of ha 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 ha, JK. I use it as kind of a buffer in vibes, keep it tangential, keep it in the realms of that postmodernism, while also throwing in, you know, other central parts of these projects' themes of just poking fun at white people in the best way possible, before pivoting back into dopeness with You Wanna Know, another great sample-laden song that flips an Elton John song track into a really tight groove. Again, that Charles Hamilton sample core at its finest. The guys ride the beat well, and it's more excellence firing off of good cylinders before having a really dope pocket of collaborations with the first of the two title tracks in Sit Down Man, a track that has Scoop DeVille production, LP doing a feature verse, and the guys just getting in the pocket, chopping it up excellently, and ending the first half of this project. And the start of the second half goes right back into the comedy with Fake Patois, a song that just dunks on everybody who's ever done a fake patois.
Snow from Toronto, fake patois.
Across the board. Another great comedy-leaning song that has a really hilariously serious aspect within culture tackled before pivoting into a sort of a melding of, again, comedy and good pen game with rapping to you. A really fantastic track that just has, again, flexing those pens, putting some great bars out there over a Nujabes beat. It's everything I would ever want from this group. And I use it as the first real serious track in this pocket of serious tracks. Because after that, we go into the Rock Marciano joint, which is a Rock Marciano joint with Das Racist. We have a lot of collaborations from the Sit Down Man era on this part of the record especially. And this is the first of many. We got a nice chill beat. We got a nice beat with some good abrasiveness underneath that before transitioning into another collaboration with amazing a track that sees Lacutis chopping up with the guys over another really smooth-ass beat. Showcasing the lushness within Sit Down Man is a lot of what this pocket is trying to do. The tight production with some cool other ideas woven in there. I like this track a lot. Similarly to Rappin' to You and Mark Marciano joint, I think it just shows Heems and Kool-Aid D's actual talents as rappers on full display, and this is kind of the best legitimate sample size without any deviations from the norm, because from there we go to Deep Ass Shit, You'll Get It When You're High, where the group is kind of just really leaning into their weed rap tip on that particular track, and again, acts as a buffer. You know, we're getting too serious, we're showing off too much talent, let's throw a distraction in there. Let's throw You'll Get It When You're High in there before going into another joke song with Puerto Rican Cousins, a song that reintroduces and reaffirms those aspects from the first half of the record at their core of just dumb shit white people say. White people do better.
Get some help.
And I wanted to keep the sort of energy in the instrumental from that track kind of alive, so I go into Rooftop, a collaboration with Despot that, again, has a little more showmanship of talent. And I wanted to keep the, again, the energy from that beat palpable, so I go into the stomping Hugo Chavez, a song where DR pays tribute to Hugo Chavez in their own ironic sort of way. Actually, I think the beat on this goes hard, and they have some good bars in there, but it's got the air of a lot of what Shut Up Dude has going on, which is like a melding of both tones, and kind of reaches a good harmonious marriage, in my opinion. I wanted to keep that melding of both tones intact by having People the Strange follow that up, another track in the vein of You Oughta Know, and Return to Innocence, and Nutmeg with a heavily, blatantly used sample and Flipped, the band chops it up, where they get a little goofy, like the hook of this song. Like, yeah, they go into some real serious subject in the bars, hit a really serious stride in pockets, but they don't lose that jovial funness or that comedic edge that people really flocked to them for these two tapes. But listen, we're getting too bogged in both sides of the coin. Let's get bold, let's get overt, let's be direct. Let's put Shorty Said next in the track listing, a song with a booming club style beat where the two guys are just talking about what people said that they look like. Again, just calling out white people for saying the dumbest shit, for being pretty fucking racist. I love it. It's not the last track like this in the track listing, but it's definitely the most bold one in this back half, and I use it as to sort of throw the listener into the last leg of the record. And throughout the last leg of the record, we have Town Business next, the payoff moment from the planting of the Amili references, with a song that has more of an overt Amili reference, with the beat at its core flipping that motherfucker I'm ill line throughout the entire track, and the band keeps referencing that line throughout the bars. It's another really good collaboration, with Casa Overall opening the track. The beat has this smooth instrumental, and I think coming off the heels of Shorty Said really, again, transitions into the back end of the record really well. I just wanted to keep the smoothness from Town Business into Ekshanish, a song that samples a Bollywood film, if I'm not mistaken, with some smooth flows, some nice low end in there, and an equal dose of well-penned and lax, goofy bars that goes really well into Free Jazzmatazz, a song that's of the same ilk, the smooth, spacey instrumental with some goofy bars dispersed throughout some well-penned verses. But we're done with the smoothness. I wanted to close Kool-Aid D's ramblings at the end of Free Jazzmatazz into the second title track, Shut Up Dude, a track with a noisy synth-driven abrasive instrumental that I use as the show-stopping finale to this double album smash. And that's really the biggest reason why it's here. It's the second half of the title, of the version of the title track that I gave it. And if I was going to close the first half with Sit Down Man, I had to close out the second half with Shut Up Dude. And that's my version of Sit Down Man, Shut Up Dude. If you want to hear it, Spotify and YouTube links are in the description. If you like this, give it a like. Let me know your thoughts on it in the comments down below. If you want to see more of my music, gaming, and general nerdery content, be sure to subscribe. Special thanks to my patrons. If you want to join the ranks to get early access to content, exclusive content, or to help drive the community, it's linked in the description. I'm going to go there. Thank you again so very much for watching. I've been Viral Rack. You guys have good days, lives, and situations, and I'll see you another day. Thank you.